All right, it's the morning at 8 a.m. Okay, it's almost 8 a.m. But basically, today is this event. No, one of the events, which is called the scavenger hunt. But before that, it's the opening ceremony. So we're gonna have a fun time at that. But before we can do any of that, we need to get some breakfast. So yeah. Well, eating breakfast now with Isaac and my teammate Mary. And we're about to soon head over and why'd you do that, Isaac? No, back off. No. This isn't my spot. Yes, this is, I don't have. Okay, so yeah, show you more footage later. Bye. Okay, so we're going over to the opening ceremony place in the CCIB right now. And I'll be showing that later. Yeah. Okay, so we're inside the opening ceremony area, and it is loud. They play Havana so many times. Yes, just continue making that face. Yeah, so let's just show you what the front looks like.
Scholars! Welcome to the 2018 Barcelona Global Round!
Scientific polls about the popularity of pineapple and pizza, and the scholars that I've met with incontrovertibly agree that pineapple does not go on pizza.
Nazi, you need to brush up on the scientific method, because I have polled thousands upon thousands of scholars at thousands of rounds all over the world, and they agree with me. Pineapple and pizza are the perfect partners. Yes.
Millions of scholars I have talked with at the billions of rounds we've had this season, they all agree that pineapple does not go on pizza. Whoa!
Roll your dough this, roll your dough that. Without pineapple, your pizza's just fat. So make that perfect shape and melt on top that perfect cheese, and then don't stop. Cover it all in tomato sauce. Don't like tomatoes either? You're lost. It is the culmination of a culinary notion. The perfect food across every land and ocean.
Get your head straight. Your argument draws a blank like a template. You want a pizza that's soggy and wet and packed and set. If it tastes like a cement grid. What do you mean a culinary culmination? It's the subject of years of cultural appropriation. I'm sorry, Canada. I know you're trying to play, but you want better trade deals. Don't attack the taste buds.
Big effect on our physical well-being, our mental well-being, and I'll go into that in a moment. But I just think it's really important that if we all just acknowledge each other a little bit more, the world would be a much better place.
Okay, so this is a little bit of commentary about what just happened. That was the opening ceremony, and to be expected, you got your introduction of the people, but for the world scholars, it's going to be more interesting, mainly because depending on which country you're in, and since we were in Spain, they had Spanish dancers perform in front of us live for free too, just for being in the World Scholars Cup. And that, I gotta admit, is amazing. And what you just saw later was a rap battle about something that they were discussing for a very long time, which is pineapple on pizza. Should it be allowed or should it not? So yeah, that's pretty much it for the opening ceremony. Well, the keynote speaker is now done. Opening ceremony is all done. And yeah, we're about to get lunch. Yeah. See ya.
Giant board just to eat lunch. Sell them that they give.
I'm gonna grab cucumber and carrots.
Add-ons. Soles, sell it.
Looks like string beans, potatoes, eggs, tomatoes, and yeah.
Chicken with lemon sauce. Pieces of bread. Eggs. And fruits.
Well, time to get ready for the scavenger hunt. We're gonna have to wait for everyone else to go.
This is just for the area to get food.
So that was the scavenger hunt. That was basically all to it. The parts that I forgot to include was the actual task that you needed to do, which was sort of tedious, but it gets you exploring the area. And since we were at the Spanish village, there was a lot of interesting things that we did there. There are some exercises looking for the staff that works at the World Scholars Cup and asking them to do some task for you, like bribing them so you can get something in return, or even having them sing Havana too. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that basically the scavenger team pairs you up with people around the world too. So it is possible for you to get, let's say, if you're from America, you can be teamed up with people from like Israel, South Africa, China, and all the other places that the World Scholar has been in touch with. Then comes exploring other places within the Spanish village to get a feel of what it's like to be in that area. And then comes the dinner that they provide at the end.
So the options were a hamburger, hot dogs, about this long, and pizza. Yeah, that's all they had.
That was the dinner. And the stage too, they sometimes also have performers giving dance lessons like you just saw. So it's interesting to try out. And I was able to talk to some people there from different countries, and I was able to get some stickers from them from their respective countries, which was an upside to me. So now I basically have more stickers from people around the world, and I'm happy about that. More stickers to my collection. So yeah, that does it for this video. I'll release the second day with other events hopefully soon, and I hope you all enjoy. Peace out, signing off. Next feast, eating more. And again, everywhere around the world. Or at least in San Jose for the most part, where I live. So yeah.